Hi, today in this series, Exponential Economy, we'll be talking about Jevons Paradox. What it is, you will find in the next part. See you after the break. Jevons Paradox, what is it about? It is a term used in economy, and it is all about resource consumption. There is this general assumption that if you increase the consumption efficiency of some resource, then the usage, the consumption, the general consumption, the rate of consumption of that resource in the economy will decrease, right? Because this is like, let's say, simple logic, right? Each device consumes less energy, then the general consumption throughout all devices will decrease. But there are situations where the increased efficiency of resource of this consumption does not lead to decrease in consumption overall, just the opposite. In some cases, it leads to an increased consumption of that resource due to the fact that it is just cheaper to consume that good or that resource, that the use of that resource is just cheaper, and it drives demand for that resource, and that way more people or more consumers use that resource, and they use that resource maybe more intensely, and in some cases it leads to general overall consumption. And this specific situation where increased efficiency of resource consumption of a specific good, specific resource, leads to an increase of overall consumption. This specific situation is called Jevons Paradox. Why is it called Jevons Paradox? It is due to Thomas Stanley Jevons, an English economist who in 1865 published a book, The Coal Question, where they described the situation in England, where in the middle of 19th century there was a shortage of coal. They thought their resources, their coal mines, are depleted already. Of course, they were not, and they are still not depleted. But at that time, they believed the coal resources are close to depletion, and they tried to counteract that fact by increasing the efficiency of use of coal. And one of the great efficiency increases was the steam machine invented by Thomas Watt. And that machine used less coal for the same amount of work that was produced, in comparison, of course, to the methods that were used before. You would say, in order to produce the same amount of goods, you needed less coal to do that. And this is what the economists at that time assumed, that, you know, the invention of the steam machine would lead to less coal consumption. But the opposite was the case, because of two reasons. The first reason was because you needed less coal to produce a certain amount of products. The production of that product was cheaper, so the demand for that product got higher, so they needed to produce more of that product, and they needed, of course, more coal to produce to do that, right? This was the first reason. And the second reason was the companies who were doing that, they were, of course, more profitable. They increased their profits because of that new technology, and that led to the investment power. They could buy or build more of such machines, and then consume, of course, more coal. And maybe more people wanted to do that because production of some product became profitable, and so on and so on. So William Stanley Jevons made that observation 1865 and predicted that the increases in efficiency in coal consumption will not lead to a decrease in the overall coal consumption. It will actually speed up the depletion of the coal in England. And you can think of other examples for that paradox. For example, the fuel usage of cars. Since 1970s, the car engines have been improved considerably, and there is more and more increase in the efficiency of fuel usage in cars or of fuel consumption in cars, but the overall consumption of fuel in the world, of course, increases. And this is another example of that phenomenon, of that paradox. And I want to invite you to discussion below that video about other examples of that paradox and maybe how it applies to Bitcoin. How can we use that paradox, that Jevons paradox, in Bitcoin? Or maybe what impact does it have on Bitcoin economy? I hope you could learn something in that video. If you liked it, give me a thumb up. If not, of course, thumb down. Share this video with your loved ones. Subscribe if you haven't, but first of all, subscribe to the newsletter, because YouTube does not always notify you about new videos. If you subscribe to the newsletter, you will get notified about videos, about maybe live events, about interviews with me, about my articles. So if you like this video, share this video with your loved ones, with your friends. One day they will thank you for that. I talk here a lot about economy, in this series about exponential economy, about money, about cryptocurrencies, about doing great impossible things in your life and business, and about the best entrepreneurs of our times, how the best, the self-made billionaires of our times think and act. So if you like this video, you will certainly like my other videos. I invite you to watch them. That's it for today. I wish you a fantastic day. Let's do something extraordinary today.